Welcome to AI Plan Lab. Get ready for the greatest AI updates from March 2025. My AI avatar is here to deliver the latest releases and exciting announcements in the AI world. We've got powerful new tools and features launched this month, and a peek at upcoming AI projects that were just announced. Let's dive in with enthusiasm. AI tools and releases in March 2025. We'll start with the AI tools, products, and features officially released in March 2025. These breakthroughs are available right now, showing how fast AI is evolving to help us in daily life, business, and creativity. Next-gen AI voices and transcription by OpenAI. OpenAI rolled out advanced speech models through their API. New speech-to-text models called GPT-4o transcribe achieve state-of-the-art accuracy, outperforming the original whisper on understanding different accents and noisy audio. They make transcriptions more reliable for uses like meeting notes or customer support. Plus, OpenAI introduced a new text-to-speech model that you can instruct to speak in specific styles. For example, talk like a sympathetic customer service agent. This allows developers to give AI voices distinct personalities. These models became available on March 20th and let apps have more natural, customized voice interactions. Talk about finding a voice, literally, for your AI. Google releases Gemma 3 open models. Not to be outdone, Google launched Gemma 3 on March 26th, its latest family of open AI models for developers. Gemma 3 models are designed to be lightweight yet powerful, making them easier to run in various applications, even on smaller devices, without heavy cloud requirements. They're also multimodal, meaning they can understand text, images, and even short videos. Google touts major improvements in reasoning and logic with these models, aiming to support everything from smarter chatbots and better search to code generation assistants. In other words, Gemma 3 is the most powerful AI model you can run on your own hardware, bringing high-end AI capabilities to a broader developer community. It's a big step in Google's effort to democratize AI tech. Alibaba's Qwen 2 open-source AI model. From China, Alibaba made waves by open-sourcing a new AI model called Qwen 2 on March 27th. Qwen 2 is optimized for running AI agents cheaply and efficiently. It supports multiple languages and can even run on low-resource devices. This means startups and researchers can use Qwen 2 to build their own AI assistants or tools without needing a massive server budget. Alibaba's move challenges Western AI labs by providing a powerful model free to use and adapt. It's part of a trend toward open AI development, sharing models so the whole community can innovate. For developers looking for cost-effective AI, Qwen 2 could be a game-changer, making high-quality AI more accessible worldwide. Samsung adds AI drawing assistant to Galaxy phones. AI is also coming to the palm of your hand. Samsung's latest One UI 7 beta, rolled out March 26th, introduced an AI drawing assist feature for Galaxy devices. This tool helps users sketch and create art more easily on their phones. For example, if you draw a rough shape or doodle, the AI can automatically enhance your sketch, apply art styles, or even generate backgrounds and details to complete the artwork. It's like having a creative assistant built into your phone's drawing app. This AI drawing assist marks a fun and creative leap in mobile AI integration, allowing anyone, not just professional artists, to make polished artwork with a little help from AI. Your Galaxy phone just got a lot more artsy. Oracle's AI Agent Studio for businesses. In enterprise news, Oracle introduced a powerful platform on March 20th called AI Agent Studio. It's a toolkit built into Oracle's Fusion Cloud apps that lets companies create and manage their own AI agents, essentially custom chatbots or assistants, for various business tasks. Oracle had already embedded over 50 AI agents in its software. Now customers can extend those or build new ones tailored to their needs. The studio provides templates and pre-built skills so that even non-developers can spin up an AI agent to, say, handle HR inquiries, assist with finance workflows, or help in customer service. Importantly, these agents are enterprise-grade, with testing tools, security, and the ability to orchestrate teams of agents working together. and it's free for Oracle Cloud customers. This launch highlights that AI isn't just consumer-facing, it's being infused into the workplace to automate processes and boost productivity. Businesses can now have their own digital coworkers customized to their operations. Meta's AI assistant debuts in Europe, with restrictions. Meta's AI made a big move in March. Meta AI assistant rolled out across 41 European countries on platforms like Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, and Messenger. European users can now invoke at Meta AI in chats to ask questions or get help, similar to how US users have had it since 2023. However, due to strict GDPR privacy rules, the EU version of Meta AI is significantly limited in features. It cannot generate images or personalize selfies like it can in the US, and it only offers a basic chat queue and AMP, A in 6 languages for now. Meta had to assure regulators that the AI wasn't trained on European personal data, after facing delays and legal hurdles. Despite fewer features, Meta is excited to finally launch their assistant in Europe, saying, "We're glad we're finally here." They plan to expand capabilities over time as compliance issues are resolved. This launch shows how tech companies are adapting AI products to different regional laws. For European users, it's a first taste of Meta's generative AI, albeit a cautious one. AI developments and projects announced. Now let's switch to AI developments and projects announced in March 2025 that hint at what's coming next. These are not available yet, but they're big news because they show where AI is headed in the near future. Buckle up, the future looks exciting and a little wild. Larry Page's new AI startup, Dynatomics. Google's co-founder Larry Page is back in the game. He quietly launched a new AI startup called Dynatomics in early March. This venture aims to revolutionize manufacturing with AI. How? By using machine learning to automate product design, generating optimized blueprints for objects that can be manufactured more efficiently. Essentially, Dynatomics wants AI to invent better designs for everything from gadgets to industrial parts, streamlining how products are developed. Page has enlisted a specialized team of AI engineers, led by the former CTO of his flying car company, Kitty Hawk. The project is still in early stages. No products yet, but it aligns with a growing trend, using AI to design and optimize physical things. Other startups are doing similar work. For example, Orbital Materials uses AI to discover new battery materials. With Larry Page's vision and resources, Dynatomics is definitely one to watch. It could usher in an era of AI-driven manufacturing, where factories make smarter, AI-designed products. Anthropic CEO predicts AI coding breakthroughs and more. Here's a bold prediction that had everyone buzzing. Dario Amodei, CEO of Anthropic, the firm behind the Claude AI assistant, said in March that AI could be writing 90% of all code in 3 to 6 months. And in 12 months, AI might be writing essentially all of the code. He shared this vision at a Council on Foreign Relations event, suggesting an extremely fast progression toward AI doing most software development. Amodei believes developers will still guide AI in the near term, providing specs and designs, but AI systems will rapidly learn to handle those tasks too. He extended this optimism beyond coding, suggesting that eventually AI can do everything humans can across industries. Keep in mind, Anthropic is racing to improve Claude's capabilities and has heavy backing from Google and others. Not everyone agrees with his timeline, but if even partially true, this hints that by 2026, we might see a world where AI systems are the primary programmers. It's both exciting and challenging. The software industry could be turned upside down. The takeaway: one of AI's leaders thinks superintelligent AI is coming sooner than most expect, and we'd better prepare for massive changes in how we work. Databricks and AMP, Anthropic team up on AI for business. Two big players, Databricks, a data analytics platform, and Anthropic, AI research company, announced a partnership on March 27th to make enterprise AI development easier. The goal is to integrate Anthropic's Claude AI models directly into Databricks platform. Why does this matter? Many companies use Databricks to handle big data, And now they'll be able to build and deploy AI agents and applications with Claude's intelligence inside their existing data tools. In short, it will be simpler for organizations to adopt secure, scalable AI solutions without needing separate infrastructure. Anthropic benefits by getting Claude into the hands of more enterprise customers, competing with OpenAI's Azure offerings. This partnership reflects a broader trend: AI companies joining forces with cloud and data platforms to bring AI to where the data lives. For businesses, it means less friction to implement AI, no need to reinvent the wheel. We can expect new enterprise AI features emerging from this alliance later in the year, making corporate data analysis and automation smarter. It's like plugging Claude's brain directly into business workflows. NVIDIA's personal AI supercomputers and AMP, next-gen chips. March is when NVIDIA, the AI hardware giant, holds its GTC conference, and 2025's GTC delivered. Jensen Huang's keynote introduced new personal AI supercomputers and teased the next generation of AI chips. First, NVIDIA revealed the DGX Spark, a compact device about the size of a Mac Mini and a larger DGX station tower. These are essentially plug-and-play AI supercomputers for developers and researchers to fine-tune and run large AI models right at their desk. The DGX Spark, priced around $3,000, is powered by a powerful GB10 Grace Blackwell chip and can deliver up to 1,000 TOPS, trillion operations per second, for AI tasks. The DGX station uses an even beefier GB300 Blackwell Ultra processor with 20 PFLOPs of AI performance and a whopping 784 GB of memory. These machines, available for pre-order now with shipments expected in the summer, mean you no longer need a giant server room to do serious AI work. It can sit in an office or lab. NVIDIA's new DGX station, the Gold Tower, and the mini DGX Spark, small box in front, are personal AI supercomputers designed to bring high-end AI computing to desks and labs. NVIDIA also hinted at its next-gen chip architecture, codenamed Vera Rubin. Set to follow the current Blackwell generation, Vera Rubin GPUs are expected next year, aiming for roughly 3x performance improvements and more efficient scaling of AI models. Fun fact, Vera Rubin was a pioneering astronomer. NVIDIA often names architectures after scientists. Additionally, NVIDIA announced forming an Open Power AI Consortium with partners like EPRI, Electric Power Research Institute, to tackle the massive energy demands of future AI systems. With AI models growing, power consumption is a big concern, so they're working on solutions to manage AI's impact on electrical grids. Overall, NVIDIA's news means more power in smaller packages for AI computing and planning ahead to support the AI boom sustainably. It's exciting for anyone eager to train AI models. Soon a lot more people will have supercomputer-level AI boxes in hand. Meta teases voice-centric Llama 4 model. Meta isn't just rolling out existing AI, they're cooking up new ones. In March, Meta's chief product officer teased the upcoming Llama 4, calling it an omni-model with a focus on voice. Unlike typical AI assistants that convert your speech to text and then respond, Llama 4 aims to handle native speech input and output directly. Chris Cox, Meta's CPO, described a future where you can talk to an AI agent naturally, and it will understand and answer without that intermediary step of text transcription. Meta believes conversational voice interactions are the future of AI agents, not just typing chat messages. They've been heavily investing in AI, with CEO Mark Zuckerberg earmarking up to $65 billion in 2025 for AI projects. Llama 4 is expected to be a big part of that, possibly tying into Meta's AR/VR and wearable plans too. Imagine voice assistants that feel almost human in how they communicate. While details are under wraps, improved voice features and more natural dialogue are on the roadmap. Llama 4's release date isn't confirmed, but Meta is hinting it's coming soon. If it delivers on being an omni-model, we might be able to have free-flowing conversations with AI that feel much more real and intuitive. Talking to your digital assistant could become as easy as chatting with a friend. Those were the major AI announcements of March 2025 that are setting the stage for what's next. From AI designing products and writing our code, to new partnerships and hardware enabling the next generation of AI, it's clear this field is accelerating rapidly. It's hard not to be excited, and maybe a little nervous, about these developments. In summary, March 2025 brought us huge leaps in AI capability, more creative tools in our hands, smarter assistants in our devices, and big plans for the near future, like voice-first AIs and super-efficient AI systems. We can't wait to see how these play out in the coming months. It's amazing how much can happen in just 1 month of AI news. We hope you enjoyed this whirlwind tour of March 2025's AI highlights. Which AI development are you most excited about? Each of these has the potential to change how we live and work, from creative pursuits and daily convenience to industry and infrastructure. On AI Plan Lab, we'll keep bringing you these updates so you're always in the loop with cutting-edge AI. Thank you so much for watching. If you learned something new or are just as excited about AI as we are, smash that like button and subscribe for more AI news and deep dives. Together, let's plan for an AI-powered future. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time on AI Plan Lab.